Today, I would like to speak about simplifying the text in your documents. So I'll show you how to change the text document, like this on the left, into the more simple form, which is, can be seen on the right side. And the essence is actually realizing which kind of, what text would you use for spoken communication versus information which you would put in some written form, so something to be read. That will help us actually to simplify the text a lot. So let's see the specific example. Here I have a text, some mini article speaking about a different way of understanding the AI, how the using AI can look pretty simple from outside, but from inside it contains several levels of steps, several implementation steps. So when I receive the source information like that, I take some time to understand the content if it's not written by me. And then I try to highlight the essential parts. So for this one, you can just use the making text thicker by making bold. So in bold, I highlighted the words which are the essential here. So that gives me the first level of understanding which parts can be actually skipped. And then let's have a look at these things which are not essential. And here we can see the words like may seen, however, these are the fill words which you would use when you would speak to someone, but in written form we can skip them totally. Also, when you have listing of the items like take data, do this one and that one, these things also could be replaced by a simpler form. So the same way as I did here. So for example, here may seen, we can remove it all. We can replace comma by plus. So get just the essence, three steps, which are the essence of this sentence. Also things which you can notice here is the repeating words. So like take data, apply a method to the data. These are these repeating things which we can also skip and just mention it once. Also the thing which you can remove is that when you have something like a list of items usually, or saying like here, like we can go in several areas and then follow the list of areas follows, then what you can just replace it by column. So that's what I am going to do here. Next thing which you can spot are the words which express words, the structure. So firstly, then the last part. These words indicate that there is some structure, there is some process. So these things we can replace by numbering. The similar way as we can replace this list of items by bullet points. So you can see the idea how you can work this with the text, what you can replace. And once you have this working text cleaned, you'll get form content like that, which is simpler, easier to read, easier also to understand the structure. So just to summarize this quick method, how to simplify the text, realize differences between spoken and written, search for filler phrases which are used in spoken form but could be eliminated totally in written form, also search for repetitive words which we tend to use in spoken form but they can be skipped in written form, and also can replace some text by symbols. Like I showed you, numbering, bullet points, column are the much more shorter and simpler symbols which covers the similar information. So this way we can move from this format to this one. We can go a step further and also try to use the visual aids, but I would leave this one for next video. So for the moment, I'll just show you the kind of teaser, what we can do with this kind of text. You can try to express it by diagrams or by some block format, more visual form, and how to do it, I'll explain in my next video. So meantime, I just encourage you to follow me, not to miss it. Or if you want to learn more and get more tips and resources, I invite you to go to our website, infodiagram.com/freesample. You can there sign up for my email tutorial. You will get a series of three emails with more tips how to use visual aids to improve your communication.